Hey, Mr. Rose, you sure were enjoying that song about Mona Lisa.
I sure was, son. That song right there is one of my favorites. Have you ever heard it before?
Nope. Who was the guy singing? He sounds smooth.
Oh, that, my friend, was none other than Nat King Cole. That brother has a voice that is cool as ice. Have you heard any of his other songs before?
I think so. Isn't he the unforgettable guy? My Granny Maxine has played him around the house before.
That's him. My guy Nat King Cole was one of the coldest brothers to ever come out of Montgomery, Alabama.
I didn't know he was born there.
Oh yeah, I have a lot of kinfolk back there. And to the world, they know him as an entertainment icon. But his life started out there on March 17th in 1919, where he was born to a preacher father and a piano-playing mother. Nathaniel Adam Coles was destined to become something special.
Why do you say that?
Well, with a mother who was a talented pianist. Of course, she taught Nat how to play the piano. He began playing the piano at an early age and even started singing in church and with his brother, too. But check this out. You want to hear one of the legends of Nat King Cole?
The legend of Nat King Cole? This sounds juicy.
Growing up, there were stories of Nat King Cole sneaking out to hear other musical legends.
Really? Like who?
According to legend, Cole would sneak out of his parents' house and sit outside clubs to listen to performances by music icons like Louis Armstrong, Earl Hines, and Jimmy Noon.
Like I said, that unforgettable song makes my Granny Maxine dance and sing as she's cleaning around the house.
I understand. Songs like Mona Lisa, Unforgettable, and When I Fall in Love were just a few of Cole's top songs. It made him one of the most successful recording artists on Capitol Records.
And isn't he the chestnut dude?
The chestnut dude? Oh, you're talking about the Christmas song. That is a holiday classic with Nat King Cole's voice sounding smooth like butter as he sings Chestnuts Roasting on an Open Fire.
That's the song. My Granny Maxine plays that during the holidays, where he sings like Joy to the World and Silent Night too.
Boy oh boy, you sure got me going today, son. I'm telling you, Frankie, Nat King Cole was a bad man. I mean, the brother not only was next level with music, but he even became a first in television.
What did he do?
Frankie, he was so popular that he used his influence to become the first African-American to host a network variety show. It was called the Nat King Cole Show, which debuted on NBC in 1956.
Nice.
Oh, if you want to talk about nice, he even made his way into acting. Some of his biggest films include films like Istanbul, China Gate, Night of the Quarter Moon, and Cat Ballou.
I never knew he was such an influencer.
Yeah, he sure was. From being a Grammy Award winner to an entertainment icon, Nat King Cole definitely will be missed.
How did he die?
Son, it's a sad story. In 1964, he discovered that he had lung cancer. Just a few months later, he passed away on February 15, 1965, at the age of 45 in Santa Monica, California.
Now that's an incredible story, Mr. Rose. It sounds to me like even though his life was short, it was an amazing one.
You said it, my friend. He lived a life that was unforgettable.